Sometimes it seems like everywhere you turn, people are talking about some sort of economic news. Politicians accusing each other of pushing the economy into recession. The adults in our lives complaining about the price of things like milk, bread, and gas. Television reporters casually discussing inflation and unemployment numbers. And let's be honest, so many people are saying things that seem to contradict each other. It's hard to tell who's right and who's wrong, or even if all these folks live in the same universe. Plus, it feels like anytime you think about asking a question, someone throws out a big word or a technical term to try to talk over your head or around you. Frankly, it can make a person want to just tune everything out and go about with their day-to-day life. But as tempting as that sounds, you also realize that you want the economy to be healthy, with plenty of jobs that pay enough for you to not only get by, but to thrive. So, how can you tell if the economy really is healthy? In this unit, we're going to examine some of the key economic indicators that are used to measure the overall health of an economy, like growth and inflation. We'll also try to figure out what some of these indicators mean and how we can use them to make more informed decisions. Today, we're going to look at the cycles of an economy, and by the end of the lesson, you should be able to answer the following questions. How do we determine the overall health of an economy? Why do people experience the economy differently? What are some questions that you can ask to better evaluate the health of an economy? You should also begin to consider our big picture question: why is determining the overall health of an economy so complicated? In a perfect world, an economy would always be growing and getting better. Unfortunately, that isn't the case. Economies are cyclical. An economic cycle is the natural, cyclical pattern of economic growth and contraction that occurs in a market economy. In other words, there are good times and then there are bad times. For example, the glitz and glamour of the Roaring Twenties was followed by the hard times of the Great Depression. An economic cycle has four parts. Expansion is a period of growth. The peak is the highest point of an economic cycle. That's followed by contraction, which is a period when an economy is experiencing a decline in economic activity. And finally, there is a trough, the lowest point of economic activity in a cycle. From there, the process repeats. Now, normally the highs and lows aren't as extreme as the ones experienced in the 1920s and 1930s, but there can be extended periods of contraction. A recession is a period of significantly declining economic activity that lasts for at least 2 fiscal quarters, which is the equivalent of 6 months. Now, let's take a moment to check in. Say one of your neighbors is upset and saying the country is going downhill because the economy is doing poorly. What could you say to your neighbor to help ease their concern? Sometimes it's really easy to think of an economy as one big thing, when in reality, it is made up of many different markets and industries that work in collaboration and competition. Changes to any of these different markets and industries are felt differently by different stakeholders. Let's say that electric cars become more affordable and popular. Automobile manufacturers may see growth and improvement. But at the same time, the oil and gas industry may see contraction. Different places and regions are also impacted differently. Let's say that the state of Georgia offers incentives to entertainment companies to film movies in the state. Well, if you're an actor in places like Atlanta or Savannah, you may see an increase in work and wages. But at the same time, actors living in Hollywood might start earning less. And finally, income and wealth also impact how individuals experience changes in an economy. While it might not be fair, having greater income and more savings makes it easier to weather those downtimes. Some folks work in industries that are impacted less by economic changes, or have the sort of education and training that allows them to switch industries when needed. All right, time for another guiding question. Say folks in your town are upset that even though times have been difficult for them recently, the national newspapers are saying that the American economy is on the right path. How would you explain this disconnect between what the news is saying and how people in town feel about the economy? If we know that there are cycles of growth and contraction for economies, why do people disagree about the overall health of the economy at any given time? Well, that's because, unfortunately, it's very difficult to measure economic growth in the moment. Big events like the stock market crash that led to the Great Depression, the kind where everyone can agree about what's happening in an economy, happen very rarely. The signs and signals that the health of an economy is changing are often subtle and not easy to see. Instead, we need to ask lots of questions and look at different economic indicators. First and foremost, we need to try to determine whether the economy is growing or contracting. Figures like the gross domestic product give us insight into what is happening in terms of growth. A healthy, growing economy sees more people working and earning higher wages. That means it's helpful to ask ourselves, are jobs being created or lost? And what's happening with wages? Job growth and rising wages are great, but what happens if the prices for goods and services are increasing faster than wages? Looking at economic indicators like inflation and the consumer price index help us get a better idea about what is happening with prices. And remember, not everyone experiences the economy the same way, so that might mean digging deeper into overall economic indicators to see what is happening in different areas and at different income levels. What if overall wages are increasing, but only because a small number of people at the highest income levels are making even more money, while folks in the middle and lower ends of the economic spectrum are finding it harder and harder to make ends meet? Is that the sign of a truly healthy economy? Now, it's also important to remember that when you analyze and evaluate an economy, it's best to look at as many different economic indicators as possible. After all, the more data, the better the analysis. Time for a check-in. Say one of your neighbors is talking about how the increasing cost of gasoline means that the country is about to go into recession. What questions would you ask them to evaluate their claim? Let's take a second to recap what we've covered. A market economy is cyclical, with periods of expansion and contraction, but extended periods of contraction are called recessions. And while we often talk about the economy as a whole, it is important to remember that people experience it differently, depending on things like where they live and how much money they make. As we start to evaluate what part of the economic cycle we are in, we need to examine as many economic indicators as possible and be sure to ask questions to help us better assess the state of the economy. Tomorrow, we're going to be discussing economic growth and the gross domestic product. Till then, remember to keep investing in yourself one lesson at a time. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.